Facebook Live. This is Pastor Mark Witherspoon coming to you from Milwaukee, Wisconsin, via Tupelo, Mississippi. Amen. Amen. Coming on you this morning on behalf of Spoon Fed Ministries. Amen. Of Milwaukee, where I am the pastor. Amen. The apostle pastor of this ministry. Amen. Amen. Let us pray. Dear gracious Heavenly Father, we come to you this morning right now, God, with a bowed head and a humble heart, asking, oh Father, for forgiveness of our sins, God. Asking right now, Father, that you clear our minds and our hearts to receive what thus say the Lord. God, cleansing and making a way as we go through this a stage of our life with this epidemic that's out here right now in the name of Jesus. Making it clear, touching our loved ones, God, keeping us safe. Most of all, God, keeping us in a praying mood. And Lord, keeping us in a mood of forgiveness and love. And now, Father God, I ask in the mighty name of Jesus that you come inside me, God. Let it not be me that the people see or hear, but let it be thus the Holy Ghost. Use me right now, God, like never before. In the mighty name of Jesus, let your word, as the Bible says, will not come back to you void. And God, we just ask that. We ask these and other blessings in thy precious son Jesus' name. Amen. And thank God. Amen. Once again, I'm Pastor Apostle Mark Witherspoon, coming to you from Milwaukee, Wisconsin, on behalf of a ministry that God has given me. It has nothing to do with my name. So believe that. It's Spoon Fed is simply Spoon Fed. God is saying to me that people that come to me will know thus about, will know something about me. That's just who he called me to be. I'm just being honest with you. Amen. I don't think I know it all. I don't think that people that's going to come to me are going to know it all. But we're going to learn from each other. But you're going to know Jesus is the Son of God. And the only way that we can make it through this thing that we're going through right now is by his mercy and by his grace. Amen. Today, I want to talk to you. Today, I want to talk to you about a word that God has given me. And you know, let me say this before I start. I must give a much credit and much shout out to my cousin, Calvin Witherspoon of Tupelo, Mississippi, a very, very anointed man of God that God talks to, and he begins to talk to me. He said, "Cuz, listen, God said the playing field is the playing field is ripe." In other words, it's an equal playing field right now. It's a level playing field. And I don't mean that in we're playing sports, Christianity basketball or Christianity baseball, but what he's saying is that you can reach people now because folks are at home via Facebook and the internet. Amen. And my cousin told me this a while back. Let me say, cuz, I apologize for taking me so long, but understand something, that you can't just jump out of an airplane without a parachute. Because if you do, it's all over for you. Amen. So when you get ready to jump out of the airplane, you must be equipped. So when you get ready to come to Facebook and talk about God, you better be ready. And all y'all that's sitting around talking about God, I don't mean no disrespect to nobody, but be ready. Amen. Because things are coming. You're talking to somebody that's been through something. Fear has no part in my life whatsoever. Nothing can happen to me unless God allows it to be. And he loves me too much to let me in you go through anything. But you have to have that faith, that belief. Amen. So pray for me and pray with me as we go through this message. Amen. Go with me, if you will, to Matthew 14, verses 20 through 22 through 31. Matthew 14, 22 through 31. Now, if I had to give a title for this, why most of you are getting to it, if I had to give a title for this, it would be the title would be Jesus is always there. Amen. Jesus, amen, is always there. Amen. Amen. Let us read from Matthew 22. And it says, I'm reading from the King James Version, and it says, and straightway Jesus constrained his disciples to get into a ship and to go before him to the other side while he sent the multitude away. Now, understand something. At this particular time, Jesus had fed the 5,000. Jesus was in a place where he had taken care and healed a lot of folks that day. He had put in, understand me, a lot of work this day. So he says, and straightway Jesus constrains his disciples, I'm 22, to get into a ship and go before him unto the other side, while he sent the multitude away. And when he had sent the multitude away to pray, and when the evening was come, he was there alone. Amen. You see, now Jesus went off to pray. Right now, at this particular time, a test was coming for the disciples. We got to understand something, that when you are a child of God, there are tests coming. Just like in school, things are going to come. Things are going to show up in our lives when we're in Christ Jesus. Jesus was tested on a daily basis by Satan. Come on, y'all. You said, pick up my cross. You know, we got a quick say, pick up my cross. And I'm walking to you. When you pick up your cross, understand something, that Jesus picked up his cross. He was bruised and battered. He walked around with thorns around his head. It was no easy walk. But he did. He did it. He was mocked. He was laughed at, talked about. And everything. Amen. But Jesus went to pray. See, because at this time, amen, they did not. Now, at this time, Jesus had to get recharged. If you will, virtue had to come to him. Understand something, people of God. Jesus was God and man at this particular time. In order for us to get an example of how to live, he had to live, excuse me, as man on this earth. You see, if Jesus didn't come and live as man on this earth, we wouldn't have had an example. We wouldn't have had an example of how God is and how he wants us to live. Amen. Now it says he went to pray, and when the eve was come, he was there alone. See, in the evening time, there's peace, there's quiet most of the time. You know, during the day, there's noise and everything. But in the evening, there's peace sometimes. Depends on what you're doing. If you're in the world, evening can be start of noise. amen, in trouble, in drama. But if you're in Christ, and I'm not saying we're nobody special, come on now, but if the light is in you, let that light so shine. Amen? Now, and Eve was calm. He was there long. But the ship was now, I'm on 24, but the ship was now in the midst of the sea, tossed with waves, for the wind was contrary. Now understand something. When it says the wind was contrary, the wind was very strong at this particular time. The wind was strong, the waves were high, and the disciples was in a ship going to the other side of the sea. Now, they were very much afraid, like any human being would be. There was some form of fear amongst them because, listen to me, they're only human. We're only human. And when stuff happens, there is fear going to come. But does fear stay? No. Does fear make a home in your heart? No. But listen, they were there. These were people that seen Jesus heal the blind, made the lame to walk, raised the dead. Come on, somebody. These are the men that seen all this stuff. And they still was afraid. But check this out. See, this is what I like about Jesus. And in the fourth watch of the night, Jesus went unto them walking on the sea. I want you to understand something, people of God. The fourth watch of the night is very important. See, at the fourth watch of the night is when Satan's imps and demons and who he got out working for him go back to him to report. This all happens in the fourth watch of the night, before day. Juno, it's got to still be night out and dark, you know. He's the prince of darkness. So he has to do everything at night. Jesus is of light. He's light that shineth in the dark. Satan can't do that. So he is the prince of the night. First of all, now check this out. When we're going through things in our lives and don't see, I'm getting back to the time. Jesus is always there. No matter what we're going through, Jesus is always there. See, he knew, amen, that at the fourth watch of the night, his disciples was in trouble. Because one thing, see, the demons already know, hey, that leader dude, see, they didn't know Jesus was the Son of God, but they knew that he was some strong wisdom, a powerful man that God had put down here. They didn't know he was his son, his only begotten son. He didn't give Satan that particular detail. But one thing that they knew, that he was gone and the disciples was by themselves. So let's make this sea rough and let the wind blow and let's deal with them. But see, Jesus knew this because it says at the fourth watch of the night. At the fourth watch of the night is when the Israelites was delivered from the Egyptians. Oh, somebody ought to be saying amen. On the fourth watch of the night, the Israelites were delivered from the Egyptians. God shows up on the fourth watch of the night. When we're in the midst of our trouble, when the demons, when things are crumbling down, we lost our job, our children are acting crazy, I don't know how I'm going to make this God know, how I'm going to keep food on the table, God is always there in the fourth watch of the night. But see, sometimes we forget who the King of Kings is, who is the storm calmer. Amen. Because the wind was blowing, the waves were high, and when And the fourth night of the watch, Jesus went unto them walking on the sea. Can you imagine Jesus walking on the sea when the sea is boisterous, the wind is strong, the waves are blowing all over the place, and there's like a parted just for Jesus to walk through with all this stuff going on. So everything that's going on in our lives, check this out. Jesus is right there in the midst, just like he was in the midst of that storm. Oh, I feel your Holy Ghost. Come on with it. Just like he was in the midst of that storm. See, but the disciples didn't know that because the Bible said they were afraid. Because sometimes when we don't remember the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, we'll get afraid in our storm. Amen. Verse 26, and when the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were troubled, saying, it is a spirit, and they cried out of fear. See, begin to then think that they were hallucinating. Why? Because the wind was rough, the waves are blowing, it's loud out there, and Jesus is walking on the water. Is that Jesus? Who is it? Oh, no. Oh, no. The Bible says they cried out of fear. But straightway, Jesus spoke unto them, saying, be of good cheer. It is I. Be not afraid. It is I. Be not afraid. The instant, I want you to catch this. The instant Jesus said, be of good cheer. It is I. It is I. I am the great I am, the first and the last, the Alpha and the Omega. Be of good cheer in the midst of your storm. It is I, be not afraid. Even in the midst of our storm, we have to, people of God, find a way to be of good cheer. Even though things around us are horrible and terrible, even though we're in this pandemic right now, we have to be of good cheer. Because see, there's always something we can do. If it's nothing but fasting and praying, folks say, I ain't got nothing to do. You can never pray enough. You can never fast enough. You can never talk to God enough. If you had 1,000 tongues, you couldn't praise him enough. So I don't know how in 24 hours, when some of us, 16 of that is asleep, can say they don't have nothing to do. Oh God, let me go on. God, stop it, Pastor. Let me go on. Now, and it says in verse 20, and Peter answered him and said, Lord, if it be thou, bid me to come unto thee on the water. I want y'all to check this out. There's something really spiritual that just happened when Jesus told them to be of good cheer. That's why when this Bible was written by the inspiration of God, he knew how to put every scripture so perfect and so lined up, line upon line, precept upon precept, that it cannot be confused, cannot be misunderstood. Because check this out. He said, and Peter answered him and said, Lord, if it be thou, bid me to come unto thee. I want you to understand something, first of all. Number one, the wind is blowing, and the waves are high, and it's boisterous out there. And yet, the Bible didn't say Peter yelled to Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Ghost. The Bible didn't say Peter yelled. It says Peter answered him and said, Lord, if it be thou, bid me to come unto thee. So it just said, Lord, if it be thou, bid me to come unto thee. That's like saying someone, an airplane flying over and a helicopter's landing and you trying to talk to somebody and you say, hey, just come on over and have a seat right here. only way Peter could have understood Jesus and could have known that he could talk to Jesus was by the Spirit of God. Upon this rock, upon this rock, I shall build my church. Listen at this. Flesh and blood has not delivered this. Peter had some wisdom before all of the disciples got it besides Paul. Before all of the disciples got it, Peter had it. Peter had the understanding, yet he was still afraid. And he said, come. And when Peter came down out of the ship, he walked on the water to go to Jesus. When Jesus told Peter to come, can you imagine that you could see the wind blowing? The ship, now don't forget everything, ain't nothing. He said, calm, the sea calmed down, and now everything is cool, and we're just gliding along. The ship is still tossing and turning. The wind is still blowing all over the place. There's noise all over the place, but yet and still, Peter, by faith, stepped out of the boat. Check this out. By faith, he came out of the boat. It don't say it. But the Holy Ghost, this is Peter now, and he said, come. All the other disciples, Peter was the only one. And he said, come. And when Peter was come down out of the ship, he walked on the water to go to Jesus. And when Peter came down out of the ship, and he seen, listen, it wasn't, oh God, let me go to verse 30. And it says, but when he saw the wind boisterous, he was afraid, and beginning to sink, he cried, saying, save me, Lord. Now check this out. It says, but when he saw the wind boisterous, he was afraid. You know what? The wind was always boisterous. It never stopped blowing. It never stopped. The ship never stopped tossing. It was going on when Peter stepped out the boat. But Peter was so into God. You know, sometimes how we get so into God that no matter what goes on around us, all we see is the goodness of Jesus, and how sometimes folk can throw us off our square by telling us, you know, the pastor say, I need you to sow $50. I need you to do this. I need you to, I ain't giving up. Listen, honey. Understand something, people of God. It ain't strangers that stop us from doing stuff. It's husbands, wives, children, daughters, mothers, sisters, brothers. Oh, come on, somebody. I'm telling you the truth anyway. It ain't them that stop us from doing the will of God. It ain't a stranger. It's our families. It's the ones we love. The one we care about got our ear. I don't care what a guy on the street tell me. I don't know. Come up and say, hey, Mark, I seen you come out of church trying to preach, no good rascal. Somebody I didn't know said that to me. I wouldn't pay it no attention. Now, if my cousin or my brother or somebody said that to me, I wouldn't pay it attention. I would scratch my head about it. Now, why did he say that? Why would he? But check this out. Let me get back to this. And it says, and he said, come. And when Peter was come down out of the ship, he walked on the water. But when he saw the wind, when he came out of his defocus on Jesus, when we come out of our defocus on God, then we begin to look at our circumstances and situations and forget about Jesus. Oh, come on, somebody. Long as we're got our mind stayed on Jesus, everything is good and all right, no matter if it's all out of whack. The husband done went crazy. The wife smoking so much dope she can own a cocaine factory. No matter what's happening in our life, we stay on focus with Jesus. I'm going to tell you something, people of God. It wasn't that Peter took his eyes off Jesus alone. Read the scripture. The wind was boisterous. The wind was coming. The wind was doing all of this. It was doing all of this before Peter stepped out the boat. It had nothing to do with the wind and the tossing of the ship. You know what it did? It had everything to do with the mother disciples screaming and yelling. See, the Bible don't say that either. But you have to be led by the Holy Ghost when you read the scriptures so you can understand what God is thus saying. Peter happened to look back, took his mind off Jesus because of the screaming. Are you crazy? What are you doing? Get back in the ship. Yeah, you can't get out the boat. Peter Bynum wasn't there until he started listening to those other ones who had his ear yelling and screaming. I can imagine. If you don't get it, people of God, look at the scriptures. The wind was boisterous. In the midst of the sea, tossed with waves, for the wind was contrary. Everything was already happening. Peter was not in. When he saw the wind, when he came out of his faith, and when he came out of his joy, when he came out of his love for God, when he came out, then he began to look at the circumstance in the situation, and he know he couldn't do nothing about it. But see, the one who could, see, this is what I love about Peter, what he says. But when he saw the wind boisterous, he was afraid being to sink. He cried out saying, Lord, save me. And immediately Jesus stretched forth his hand and called him and said unto him, O thou little faith, wherefore didst thou doubt? See, he doubted, but hey, he had a little faith, but Jesus didn't say, thou of no faith. He didn't say thou of no faith. He said thou of little faith. Because see, one thing about Peter, he knew who to call when he got in trouble. See, sometimes, people of God, we got to know who to call. Because Sister Betty, Cousin Frank, some things they can't get us out of. We got to call on the name of Jesus. We got to call Jesus to get out of some mess. Because he said, immediately, Jesus stretched forth his hand and called him and said, O thou of little faith. He began to sink. He cried out, Lord, save me. Because he knew at that particular time, he came right back to his senses. I know I'm sinking. I can't swim. This wind is what these waves are being. Lord, save me. And it says immediately Jesus reached out his hand. And immediately Jesus reached out his hands and he saved them. O thou of little faith, wherefore did thou doubt? The Bible says it best, people of God. It says, trouble may endure for a night, but joy, Jesus, cometh in the morning. Somebody ought to be saying amen. Listen, whenever trouble cometh in the night, joy, Jesus, cometh in the morning. Which means while you're in the midst and the demons and the stuff is happening in our life, Jesus is there. Joy is always there. And when joy comes, darkness has to go. When Jesus show up, Satan can't be around. At the name of Jesus, even the demons flee. Come on, somebody. People of God, I thank you for your time. I know this was short and this was sweet. This is how pastor preach. There's a lot of things that happens in our lives that stops us from doing the will of God. And I'm not using any excuses for nothing. But what I am saying is I'm here and I'm here to stay. Amen. My name is Apostle Pastor Mark Witherspoon. Listen, let me help you out with something. If you would like to sow into Spoon Fed Ministries or Pastor Mark, you can reach us at P.O. Box 09-0404, Milwaukee, Wisconsin, 53209. Let me repeat that again for those of you who didn't catch it. If you would like to sow or donate into this ministry, Apostle Mark Witherspoon, Spoon Fed Ministries, P.O. Box 090404, Milwaukee, Wisconsin, 53209. Listen, it will be greatly appreciated. God will bless you. If this word was a blessing unto you, just say amen. Join me again next week. We're going to make this thing as weekly. We're going to push this. It's off now. I've jumped. Jesus, save me. Because listen, I'm not quitting. I'm here till the end. Amen. Amen. I love you guys. I thank you for listening. I hope I helped somebody. I hope the word touched you. I hope God did something for you in this word, that you understand that he's always there. No matter what we're going through, Jesus is always there. Amen. Trouble endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. Amen. I thank you very much. Let us close in prayer. Dear gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you, God. We thank you for your word, God. Oh, God, I thank you for the people that you're sending to this ministry, Father. Thank you in advance, God, because, see, I know you're going to do it, Father, because you wouldn't have had me doing it if you didn't want me to do it, if it wasn't going to be prosperous to the kingdom of God. God, I just thank you, Jesus, for just holding on and keeping us strong and able to even come to you to listen to your word today. I've lost relatives in this pandemic to COVID-19, God, that I'm going to love and I'm going to miss, Father. I wish they were here, and I know they do. But then again, they're in a better place, Father, and I know they are. They're right there with the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. I thank you, Jesus, for this word. I pray, God, that it touched somebody's heart, that it healed somebody, God, that it pricked somebody, God, or get somebody to study a Timothy 2 and 15, God. Let them study, God. Touch somebody right now. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, God, for the strength and the wisdom that you've given us to pull through and to keep on fighting, God. Keep on fighting for our righteousness in you, our love for you, God. Giving you the honor, the praise, and the glory. Thank you, Father. Thank you for those who listened or are going to listen. In the mighty name of Jesus, thank you so much. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And thank God. You guys be blessed. Until next time.